Sunday. Can you tell I'm very excited? I am so excited for two things. Christmas is in the air, and secondly, we are starting a new series. I am so excited. I am sure you will too. Last week, we did a summary of the secrets of the early church. This week, we are looking at the nativity story. Yeah, I'm going to be talking about how Jesus came about. I'm excited to know the origin of Jesus, where he came from, who are his God, who are his father, his great grandfather, his great grandfather. Are you sure you want to know? Just hold on. We are going to do praise and worship first. Have a wonderful time in service today. God bless.
Come on, kids, we've come to lift the name of Jesus up this morning. God is here with us and we've come to give him praise.
You are here, moving in our midst. I worship you, I worship you. You are here, working in this place. I worship you, I worship you. You are.
starting a new series this week, and I hope that you enjoyed the last series on the secret of the early church. What a wonderful time we had with the secret of the early church. And this week we are starting on nativity story, the nativity story, celebrating Jesus. Now today we are going to be looking at the story on Adam and Eve sinning against God. What did they do? What did God do? But before we go ahead, I want to establish some things that you need to know. Now, God loves you regardless. What I mean by that is that no matter what you do, sin inclusive, God has loved us already. He doesn't love you less. Now, what sin does is that it separates us from God. There are consequences for the sin that we've committed, but that does not mean that God does not love us. Now, the story of Adam and Eve is the one where we see Adam and Eve sin against God. They ate the forbidden fruits. God gave them instruction, but they went against God's instruction and they did eat the fruit. Now, God sent them out of the garden into the world, but he did not leave them like that. God made provision for them. How did he do that? He covered their nakedness, because God is a loving God. Even in their sin, God still ensured that they were okay and they will be okay out there, outside of the garden. Now, even at that, God still did not leave them. God was walking with them. He provided for them. The sin has caused them to be punished, but God never left them. So sin separates you from God, but the love is eternal. God loves is eternal. Now, our sins might be great, but God's love is greater. He does not leave us to ourselves. He loves us eternally. Now, after Adam and Eve, they started giving birth to children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren, the people that disobeyed God, that they didn't love God, they didn't even know this God. And until we came to Abraham, Bible describes that Abraham was the friend of God. Abraham was the friend of God. Now, Abraham loved God. He knew God. He obeyed God. And God gave him a promise. He said he's going to be the father to nations. Now, another thing I want you to hold on to is that God makes promises and he fulfills them. He makes promises and he fulfills them. He doesn't make empty promises. At the time when he made promise to Abraham, Abraham didn't have a child. But you will see over time that Abraham gave birth to Isaac, who became father of all of us. Now, along that line also, Abraham's child started growing. Nations began to come out from Abraham. And until we got to Isaiah, the book of Isaiah, they prophesied the birth of Jesus Christ. Now, the birth of Jesus Christ was prophesied before Jesus, which also goes to say that God gives us prophecies ahead of time. He tells us things that will happen ahead of time to prepare us, to prepare the way, to prepare the people he's going to use. He told us in the book of Isaiah that a woman, an unmarried woman, was going to give birth to Jesus. And it happened exactly like that, years and years and years later. It is very important that you note these things. First, God makes provision for us. He doesn't leave us to ourselves. God provides for us even when you sin. He provides for you. But there are consequences to the sin. Your sin will separate you from God, because God is holy. He cannot behold sin. So when you sin, God moves away from you. But he expects that you ask for forgiveness. Once you ask for forgiveness and you turn away from the sin, God comes close to you. He makes provision for you. He doesn't punish you for the sin you've asked for forgiveness for. Bible says God does not even remember. How awesome. Once you ask for forgiveness, God doesn't even remember it. We're just humans and we begin to remember. Last week I said, I hope God has forgiven me. My darlings, God doesn't remember. Once you've asked for forgiveness from a lie you told, from the pencil you took, from the lie you told mommy or your auntie in school, God has forgotten it. Just make sure you do not repeat them. That is it. Now, if you sin against God, it separates you. But God will still make provision for you in your sin. He will still protect you. He will still do the things that you have to do. We call them the basic things that the love of God will give to you. But there are special things that when you don't sin against God, the love will bring to you. Also, secondly, God gives you prophecy ahead of time. God gives you prophecy ahead of time. You prophesy the birth of Jesus Christ. Sometimes your mom will tell you, I dreamt about this thing. Sometimes even you can have a dream about something that will happen in the future. And what are you supposed to do? You are supposed to pray about them. You are supposed to tell someone so that they can pray about them for them to either come to pass or not to come to pass. That is why God gives you information ahead of time. And this is an opportunity as born-again Christians or as children of God that we have, that God gives us information ahead of time. Thirdly, God fulfills his promises. Every promise God has given to you, every promise God has given to daddy, every promise God has given to mommy, they will come to pass. I promise you. I'm not promising you. Christ promised you. And he never fails. Bible says that everything will pass away, but his word will always come to pass. So you can trust him on that, that his word will come to pass. Now, I want you to take this lesson through. First of all, God still came from the image of Adam and Eve. He came from the descendant. He's a descendant of Adam and Eve, Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, David. He came from there. God came. He gave the promises and he came through there. Secondly, God has made provision for our salvation. He has made provision for your salvation. Anybody that you are trusting that God should touch to give their life to Jesus Christ, God has made provision for them already. Thirdly, God fulfills promises. Also, he gives you information ahead of time. And once you ask for forgiveness, sin has its consequences. Don't play with it. It's very important. When you sin against God, there are consequences to sinning. But once you ask for forgiveness, he forgives you, and you must promise never to do it again. Once you do that, you are good with God. So sin does not glorify God, and you should not consciously involve in sin. But sometimes when you unknowingly fall into sin, be fast, be quick to ask for forgiveness. Don't let the devil tell you otherwise that God hates you. God never hates you. He has loved you forever. I hope you understand all that. God bless you. So let's take our memory verse. And our memory verse today is taken from the book of Isaiah, chapter 96, verse 7. Isaiah, chapter 96, verse 7. And it says, "For unto us a child is born, and unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, and the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace." I'm going to take it one more time before we go. Are you ready? All right, let's go. Our memory verse is taken from Isaiah chapter 96, verse 7. Isaiah 96 verse 7, and it says, "For unto us a child is born, and unto us a son is given, and his government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace." Hallelujah. I'll see you in the next service. Next service, we're going to be looking at some of the prophecies that God gave that came to pass. Have a wonderful week. God bless. Wow, welcome back. That was such an awesome time. To know that Christ came, started from Adam and Eve down to Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, David. Wow, that was awesome. I hope you know that God still loves you in spite of your sin. Yes, he does. So but sin separates you. Sin will not allow you to enjoy some promises God made. God will help us not to sin against him. So today, I want you to start practicing what you've heard in service today. So let's take our memory verse. And our memory verse today is taken from the book of Isaiah chapter 96, verse 7. And it says, "For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace." One more time. Isaiah 96, verse 7, and it says, "For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace." God bless you. Have a wonderful week. Next week, we'll look at some of the prophecies that God gave and has come to pass. Have a wonderful time. Stay blessed.